In 1882, the famous surgeon Mr. Theodore Bilros said, "Any surgeon who thinks of stitching a wounded heart should lose the respect of all his colleagues." The reason why Bilros thought so is the logical fact that the heart is at all times full of blood and moving. Any attempt to stop the heart or empty it from blood inevitably lead to the death of the patients. Surgeons refrained from addressing any major pathologies and confined themselves to minor pathologies which can be operated on a beating heart. This was the case for 100 years. In the early 50s, Bilros discovered that giving potassium into the coronaries can safely stop the heart in a reversible manner. Unfortunately, he used the wrong dose and concentration, and this led to the unbearable complications, namely intractable VF, myocardial necrosis, and poor contractility. This led to a boycott of the technique lasting almost 15 years. During this period, several alternative techniques were recruited. Such techniques include, for instance, fibrillating heart, hypothermia, and continuous coronary perfusion. In the late 60s, interest was revived in cardioplegia, and research evolved the technique to its current status. The merit of this story is, during this evolution process, the alternative techniques which developed were kept valid for use when needed. I'm not talking about non-cardioplegic techniques only, but also alternative variations of the cardioplegic technique. Various modalities were developed in terms of the solution used, delivery methods and delivery modes. Every variation had its pros and cons, which makes it suitable for a certain case but not the other. Every surgeon has a constant technique which is favorable and how it should be. Nevertheless, the surgeon must be equally flexible and be able to variate his technique according to the case. In this chapter, we will go through the rationale of every technique, including the pros and cons and when to use what. Please subscribe to our dedicated YouTube channel to be able to post more videos and cover more topics in the cardiothoracic surgery theoretical curriculum. Thank you very much.